Okay, next, this is the practice assignment that we're going to work on for foreshadowing. So let me go through a little bit of this together with you. All right, let's see if I can. Here we go. Increase. All right, so let's just look at the first box, the one that's already filled in for you. All right, so right here, foreshadowing. A writer uses foreshadow to give clues about what could happen later in the story, which is what we already talked about, and it's what the examples in the video that I pointed you to on YouTube. It's the same thing of what they talk about. So across the top, we've got foreshadowing, we've got an example, and then here's what might happen later in the story based on the example. Okay, so this is where we're going to make some inferencing based on the clues given us in the foreshadowing section. Okay, so foreshadowing can be where the author gives you a clue about a character. Foreshadowing could be maybe a clue about the plot, like what might happen next. So when we're looking down here, it could involve a clue about the plot. Foreshadowing could be a clue about an upcoming problem. And of course, foreshadowing can also be a clue about events in the story, like other things that are going to happen. So let's look up here at the top. We're going to look at how foreshadowing can be used to tell us a little bit more about a character. So let's read the example together. This is the example of foreshadowing. Mrs. Dennis was not one to put up with anything. If a child in the neighborhood even took a walk down the sidewalk in front of her house, she would give that child a mean look, shoo him on his way, except for Eric. Mrs. Dennis thought Eric looked like he was maybe the one and only nice kid on the block. Okay, so if that's something that we're reading, let's think about what this excerpt might be foreshadowing. What might happen later in the story based on that information? So here's one way to think about it. Well, maybe Mrs. Dennis isn't all that bad. This makes me think that maybe she and Eric might even become friends, and then maybe Eric will show her that the other kids are good too. Do I have evidence in this example over here to support my idea? Yes, I do. So maybe Mrs. Dennis is not all that bad. So maybe this right here, she thought Eric looked like he was maybe the one and only nice kid on the block. This example supports the idea or the thought that maybe she's not all that bad. Maybe she and Eric might become friends later on because it says over here that she basically looks meanly at other kids and shoos them off of her property. She shoos them out of her way and moves them on their way. But it sounds like she's not doing that with Eric. So maybe she's had a bad experience before. Maybe something good will happen with her and Eric. Now, is this opinion, right? This right here. Is this opinion the only possible opinion based on this excerpt over here? Of course not. There might be another way to think about it. You might see other things that could be foreshadowed, and that's perfectly fine. It's not about everybody getting the one right answer here. It's about making a logical hypothesis based on information in the example. So maybe this isn't what you thought. Maybe when you were reading this excerpt, you thought that maybe you thought something mysterious is happening in the neighborhood. Maybe you thought that there's something different about Eric. It could be anything else too. But the goal is that we're trying to make a logical inference about what might happen later in the story based on the clues in the example over here. Okay, so there are three other examples, and your task is to think about what might happen later in the story based on the example. So when you come down here to number two, you're going to read about a clue about the plot. There's a clue about the plot, that might happen next. You're going to read the excerpt right here, and then you're going to go ahead and type in your response over here. Okay? Same down here. You're going to read a clue about an upcoming problem. You'll type in your response over here. And then you'll read one more clue about the events in the story, and you're going to type what might happen later in the story. It's not always about what's going to happen next. We're taking this a step further, and we're simply thinking about what clues you're finding in these examples, the ones in this column. What clues are you finding in these examples that make you think there's something being foreshadowed here? That's what you're putting over here. So these are the three that you'll work on. All right.